speaker of the day, and that's Rashmi Arora. I've eagerly waited for her to be here. It's taken quite some time, and I was introduced to her and her family, I think about 10 years back now. Yeah. And these 10 years have been a journey, from she being my client, your husband being my client, to knowing her family, to she becoming the trainer in MetaHealth. And what a beautiful journey. And she has grown, I don't know how many times. And she's a woman of substance. She's a mother. She's a daughter. She's a wife. Her biggest dream to have a house where she has all the family members there. And only when we were actually interviewing did we even realize that this has been something that has probably been the crux of her story even today. So we'll listen to her story, and I will keep prompting in between and asking her questions, because I know it's going to be, I have a feeling it's going to be emotional and something that you all are going to be able to connect. After Rashmi's talk, we're going to have Karuna, who's done a lot of self-analysis into her story. It was brilliant. I loved it. She spoke to me and said, I want to be on the show. And I said, yeah, sure. This is yours. This forum is for you guys, for everyone. So thank you, thank you, thank you so much, Rashmi, for being here. And for all of you who are supporting Rashmi and Karuna right now. Welcome.
Thank you.
So, Rashmi, can you take me to the early days of your life?
Very early days, to the time I remember, Anu.
Yeah, please.
The best part of my life has been when I was... my father moved to Zambia on deputation in 1976 for 5 years. And that was the time, I have vague memories before that, but that is the time when I have had concrete memories. So I was, I think, 5 years at that time. And we moved to Zambia, and it's a beautiful place. It was a beautiful place, I can't say about now. And that's it. Anything else?
I knew this was coming, and so I'll have to dig. So give me a more experience about Zambia. Give me how kids were. How did you adjust? Because you were a Punjabin from Delhi. And a Punjabin from Delhi in Zambia, what is she doing? What are the challenges you guys have?
That time I was not a Punjabin. I was just a small girl. Okay. And a small girl of 5 years. Who would adjust everywhere and anywhere? So the day I left from this place, Delhi, my parents were sitting in the car and I was seen nowhere. They were looking for me everywhere. And I went to a very, old lady friend of mine. And I went and told her, Didi, I'm going. But don't think that I didn't come and wish you goodbye. And I went and sat in the car and everybody was looking for me. So from there, we reached Zambia. My mother and I, we flew. So we went to Kenya. My first experience was, I didn't know at that time that in a tap, there would be hot water also. I didn't know about geysers. So I just opened the tap and we were staying at a hotel and during a stopover in Nairobi, and I burnt my hand. So... then again, after that, whatever my mama must have given me a first aid, we moved to Zambia. And from Zambia to, first we went to Lusaka and then to Kasama and then to Chichimba Falls, where we were supposed to stay. Chichimba was a very beautiful place. There were three waterfalls over there and all greenery, water, sound of water. And I still miss that. I'm a nature lover. So even today, if I sit in solitude, I will just connect to nature. So that was my first experience in Zambia. And then schooling I did in Zambia for 5 years. I was there till my younger sister was born. my elder sister had stayed back in Delhi with my grandparents at that time, so I used to miss her. And mom, dad, me, and the children were so lovely. The first experience I'll share, when I reached Chishimba, I saw children playing. So we reached there, must have reached there in the morning or the afternoon. And I said, Mama, I want to go and play. So that was the first time I did not know English at all. I just knew Hindi. So my mother said, how do I go and communicate with them? What language are they going to speak? So my mother said, go and tell them, come and play ball with me. I went there. I asked them, come and play ball with me. And I showed them my ball. And I said, come and play ball with me. They answered something. I came back and I told my mom, they have answered this. What does this mean now? So every now and then I would go like a ping pong ball and come back, and again I would she would translate that for me. That was my first experience with English. And after that I started learning English, and I also happened to learn their native language, which was Bemba. But I would not communicate with them, because they would start communicating in Bemba and I would not communicate any, they would not communicate with me in English. So I would say, okay, I can just understand a bit, not much, though I knew the language completely. And that was an experience. And then there was a time when my father had to go to a different station, wherein he told somebody to reach out to my school. But that day, in those days, we used to get cholera injections for prevention of cholera. And that was, the hospital was about 3 kilometers from our school. So we were all taken by foot to the mission hospital. And there we were given cholera injections for prevention of cholera. So when I came back to school, I realized that somebody has not come to pick us up. So we were unaware why this has happened. So in that time, before I proceed with the story, my father was, when he was posted there, the conditions of Zambian children and ladies, especially over there, was very pathetic. So they were supposed to move to the hospital or the school by foot. And the school from our place was about 12 kilometers, and the hospital was another 3 kilometers ahead. So even pregnant ladies had to move 15 kilometers by foot at that time to the hospital. So my dad made it sure that every Tuesday and Friday there would be a Land Rover going and taking people over there, and everybody would be sent to school on a Land Rover in the morning and picked up. Because I was also amongst those children. So, and I'd already made friends when I communicated with them for the first time. So this continued, and what happened was that day the Land Rover did not turn up. So we were in a fix what to do. So we started walking 12 kilometers. We had already walked 6, and we started walking 12 kilometers. I was 6 years at that time. The other children must have been 8 maximum. That's it. That was our age, approximate age. So what happened was this, when we were walking, these children had a very, very protective attitude towards me. So what they used to do is, there was a notion that time, any big Land Rover or truck or any vehicle coming, they would kidnap children. So these children, what they do, and especially Indians and Europeans. So what they used to do is we would walk on the road, and while walking on the road, suddenly one child would bend down, put his ear to the road, and then he would scream and say, okay, there is a car coming, run. And we would all go inside the jungle, which was just adjacent to the road, and they would hide me in there, and they would all pounce over me like this. I mean, like this, they used to create a shell for me. That, okay, today you have to, you are protected. Then again, when the vehicle would pass, we would come back again and on the road and start walking. After a couple of meters or kilometers, again, the same thing would happen. So this was my very beautiful experience with them in 1976. By the time I reached home, I already had fever because of that injection and about 20 kilometers of, walking 20 kilometers. So that time I just collapsed in my mother's arms. And the period before that, I had suffered a lot of, I was suffering from malaria every now and then. Every 3 weeks, I used to have high fever, high-grade fever, 106, 107. And then back to work again. I would hardly go to school for a week or so in the whole month. That was my experience with the Zambia. And then one part of Zambia is, I would love to read. The time I started picking up English, I started speaking a little bit English. So once my father had to go somewhere, so he told another friend, after this incident, that please pick up my daughter and take her to your home. I will get her from there. So I didn't understand English at that time. So my father, uncle said, so he was speaking something about Mr. Nagpal. So I went and told him, uncle, don't worry. Papa no come, me no cry. So that was one of my... first of the sentences I remember, and then I started reading. And I would go to the library. We would go every weekend to the library, and then Dad would pick up one book and I would pick up seven. And out of those seven books, I would pick up, and every time one book was repeated, six were changed. So that one book was repeated was always Snow White. Let's tell.
So Rashmi, how is your life like the Snow White? Because you don't read anything by mistake. You were reading fairy tales.
Yeah.
And you were reading English. But what you were reading was magic. What you was reading was that somebody was very beautiful and somebody was not treated well. How did that impact your life? And how is your life similar to the Snow White?
Snow White impacted me in a way that whatever happens, move on. So I would have a lot of resilience in my life. I would move on every now and then. Okay, one jolt. Okay, forget it. Move on. Leave it. And it continued and became a pattern.
Okay. For the people who do not know Snow White, could you just say what the Snow White is? A short Snow story White of what Snow White is.
Snow White is a story about a beautiful girl. And okay, thank you.
Go on.
And she had she was very young when her father married again, and so this new queen, the queen, Wicked Queen, was very jealous of her. So she would ask the mirror on the wall, tell me who is the fairest of all. And the mirror would reply, oh my beautiful queen, you are beautiful, but Snow White is more beautiful. Is the most beautiful lady, girl in the whole kingdom.
Just all of you, just to pause for a minute here. And all those children who were protecting that Snow White and were hiding her from all the jeeps were telling her, you're the most beautiful of all and we need to protect you and hide you. Continue.
So then this wicked queen's tried killing her, so she sent her to the forest, and she was supposed to be killed over there. But then the hunter had mercy on her and had left her over there.
She went to Zambia where she got malaria every 15 days. She was supposed to die, but she lived on. Continue.
That's heavy.
Yes.
So Snow White. So Snow White, then what happened was she found the dwarf. She went, found a house over there, and she went and she found that there were dwarfs. She found a bed and she went and slept over there. She ate their food, and when the dwarfs came,
these were all the dwarfs, all the children that she met over there. All the dwarfs she met there. All the time that she spent with these dwarfs, all the time that she spent with people not like her. It's not dwarfs, really.
So then after that, this she made friends with them. The wicked princess again came to know from the mirror that Snow White is still alive. So she again tried to kill her thrice. And then finally, she swallowed an apple. It got stuck in her throat. And finally, a prince came. And when the prince kissed her, the apple came out. And then she let go.
She's still finding her prince. Because the apple is still stuck till today. She found her husband, but she's still searching for the prince. Wonderful. I just wanted you to understand that sometimes what we read over and over again, we create it in our life and we don't realize why we are reading it. And today she's searching for all those children, including her own, who can protect her like those little children protected her. Who will know without she speaking that there is danger coming close to her? And who will then stand there and say to her, we are there for you and we lay our life for you, before she falls into her mom's arms, very unconscious, very tired. And then her mom will save her from all these clowns who are threatening her life. Thank you, Rashmi. I just wanted to bring that up. So, you came back to India. So, I just want you guys to understand, when she was in the place that she was, it was the forest. Remember, she said, I ran into the forest every time. It was the forest that she ran into. And she created her own world of fantasy in that forest. And when she was there, her elder sister was not there. And when she came back to India, what happened? And why did you come back to India?
We came back to India because my father's contract got over. And I was in Delhi because dad got a job at a place where there was schooling only till fifth standard. And after the fifth standard, when I would come in sixth, so there would be a problem in schooling, because that time I did not know Hindi. So now that 5 years of gap, I did not know how to write Hindi. I just knew spoken Hindi. I came back to India. I started learning Hindi again. And joined school in Delhi, stayed with my grandparents and my sister. Mom and dad and the younger sister went to Kalagar.
Very good. Can you see the family is never complete, guys? Either the elder sister is not there, or the younger sister is not there, or she doesn't know Hindi, or she doesn't know English. And she's learning the communication skills all over again.
The first time I scored 2 marks in Hindi. And I joined school on, I think, 15th July, and 1st or 2nd of August, there were there was an exam. In other subjects, I topped, but in Hindi, I got 2 out of 100. And there was a sentence, I still remember, there was a sentence to be made on Gaurav. I just wrote, Gaurav mera bhai hai. And I couldn't understand why the sentence was wrong. For me, an apt sentence.
Rashmi, what was the first sentence in English you spoke?
Papa no come, me no cry.
Very good. I hope you understand that her journey began with one sentence. And whatever she failed at, she had to keep marching ahead in that. Whether in life, it was just one subject that she failed at, in one compartment in her life where she did not get it. And her whole issue was about finding that one thing that she could not get. Okay, let's go further. From your school, where did you go?
I went to the homeopathic college. I first joined Hansraj College, Delhi. And then I tried to give my entrance exams again. But that was a time where the transition started, because after 12th, I did not join homeopathy. I said I wanted to try for my BMTs those days. So when I was giving my BHU exam, there was a very bad sore throat. And my Chachaji, who was in Delhi at that time, he took me to a doctor and to a homeopathic doctor. So the 1 or 2 days that throat was not getting better. So he took me to a friend. The next day I went and gave the BHU exam, but Some were, and I said, okay, why not give homeopathy a try? Why not I join homeopathy? Because if I can get cured in 5 minutes or 10 or 15, 20 minutes from that pain I was suffering, then there must be something which I can actually learn. So that when after that BHU exam, I went and filled up the forms for NHMC. And though I didn't get cleared in any CPMT exams, but with homeopathy, I was fit and fine. I mean, we're very, very satisfied. So somebody in my college told me, why have you joined homeopathy? There is no future ahead. First year of college, you join college in 15, 20 days and you think, okay, somebody so senior who is in a house physician and telling you the same thing. Just looked at her and said, no, my intuition would say, no, there is something which I have to do. So I moved ahead. I wanted to become a pilot. So that time when it started with the Air Force, so when I was already in the second year, and by the time I completed my internship, my age had crossed being a
pilot. Can you see, guys, always one thing is not connecting. It's either the age or the language or it's the color or it's something that's just not fitting in.
So that NHMC was a very beautiful period. I had very, very, very beautiful friends. I'm still in connect with them. And we talk almost every day for the last 30 years now. We've been friends.
And so Rashmi, what made you a doctor? There is no doctor in your house. What made you want to be a doctor, not an engineer like your dad?
I did not want to be a doctor. I wanted to do administration. I wanted to get clear my IAS exams. I was in the 10th standard, scored good marks. And I was trying to get into a school where I could get pursue history. So then mom said one day, she said, why don't you just take up science till 12th? We could have a doctor in the family. That way it started.
So she became a doctor because her mom wanted her to become a doctor. It's so interesting how we live our life, right? We don't think why we did the things that we did. And so did you get married immediately?
No, I worked for about, I think, 4 years and then got married.
So who did you get married to and what was happening there?
I got married to Dr. Dipesh Arora and he's an ophthalmologist. Got married to him in 99.
How many children do you have?
Two.
And how old are they now?
One is 20, one is 15. Beautiful children.
So what is one thing that you learned before marriage? What is one thing that you learned that you took in your marriage?
Learn to adjust.
What kind of adjustment?
It's okay to subdue yourself and make others happy.
Do you want to continue like that?
Not at all. It doesn't happen like that. So nobody can be happy by you being you making them happy. Somebody would be happy by his or her own happiness.
Very good. So what did marriage teach you? You've been married now for how many years?
20. More than 20.
And what did marriage teach you? The biggest lesson of your life. You know, you remember Ortel last time? He said the biggest lessons of my life came from my marriage. Came from commitment.
Yeah. There has been a lot of commitment in my marriage from my side. That I know. Marriage taught me that you should not let yourself down. You should stand up for yourself. And come what may, it's you who's going to stand up for yourself. And I'm very grateful to my marriage because whatever it is, I have been able to move on. And right now, and there have been very, very ups and downs. Everybody's life has it. But that period has taught me to move on and move on and concentrate on what you want to do in life. That is also very, very important.
Yes, it is.
Move on to what? Move on to your goal. Move on to your happiness. Move on to what you feel you good. Move on to your friends. And
so if your daughter was standing here today right now, Rashmi, and she was about to get married, what's the biggest message you would give her?
I would tell her, listen to your gut all the time. And marriage does not mean that you have to lose your identity at any time. You have to walk hand in hand. Okay, but that does not mean that you can subdue yourself for somebody or someone. So please keep yourself the way you are and be yourself always.
Did you always practice homeopathy?
I was in the government service for 5 years in Delhi government, and then I left homeopathy when my daughter got ill. That time I left homeopathy and moved to Chandigarh because my husband had moved over there and my daughter fell ill. So for 5 or 6 years, I did not practice homeopathy, though I was just practicing in few people whom I knew. So I immediately stopped my practice till 2010 or 11. And then I started coming back again. And then that was a time when life gave us a tough time. So I joined LPO, Legal Processing Outsourcing, for the medical summarization. That time but then at the same time I started with my clinical practice back again, and that is the time, Anu, when I met you through Sumita. So at the same time I started learning mental health and started incorporating it with homeopathy.
So you were working all the time for someone. How did you become an entrepreneur? Please tell us.
Well, that's a very big one. I should thank you for that.
I acknowledge myself and I acknowledge you for it.
And I should
tell people, please tell them about your journey.
I should thank you. I should thank my mentor, Mr. Dilip Tiwari. He is no more now. And my parents, my family, my sisters, my uncles, I should thank. This was a period in 2016 when I changed a job, and I was finding that I was losing myself. I'm not doing what I'm meant to do. I'm a clinician, and I consider myself as a good clinician. So not that I'm boasting it, it's just my pride.
She is brilliant at her work. She's not boasting. She's brilliant at her work. Yes.
So that time, what happened was I had a tough time with my older job, and they even told me that if you leave us, we will trouble you or something like that. So that time, whole of my family, as I mentioned before, stood beside me with you and with my mentor, and I left the job. And I remember, Anu, those words, still I remember. Rashmi, leave it. Leave it and go. You have to leave it and you have to come out of it. I was very scared. Leaving it, leaving a salary, coming back to zero, bringing it back again would take years. But then I left it and go. And I am happy, very happy today that I did that. I could do that. And then
how many years now that you've been having your own business?
4.
And no,
2016, I think, 4 years, yes.
How is the journey?
Oh, it's lovely. The journey is so lovely. I mean, I've been learning every day. Every day there is something new turning up. And I'm so excited at times. I'm so amazed to connect things. Like yesterday I was talking to a friend, and we were communicating and we were doing her case. And then I said, yeah, something missing over here. We can use this also. So she said, yeah, perfectly. That's good. So learning each and every day and mixing human psychology with the physiology has been taught by another two mentors of mine, Dr. Dilip Soni and Dr. Jaswant Singh Jain, which has been a very amazing journey. So in this journey, I have had a lot of friends. I've had a lot of people whom I'm able to reach out now. And I still remember when I first worked that, yes, I have to reach out to more people now.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So I'm going to say it the way it's coming, Rashmi, with your permission. Life is never perfect. Yes. We want it to be. Yes. And we wait all our life for life to become perfect. You can either keep waiting for life to become perfect, or you can make whatever it is look perfect and create from there. And Rashmi is a true example of not a perfect life, but abundant life. An abundant life right from going to Kenya, where different experiences to, not having her family complete ever because somebody was always missing in the family. And she still has to sort that out because we picked that up like 2 days back. And from there, creating, always getting scared, 2 marks in Hindi, no English, no entrepreneur skills. And then she just needs a little bit of support. You know what support she needed? Her mom standing on one side. And she asking, what do I say now? And then going and telling the kids and the kids saying something to her. And then she coming back and then going this. That's all she needs. From a friend, from me, or from anybody else. And if she can keep doing this, she will not just learn, which she has done, but she has created her practice. She's a trainer of Metta Health, very well done. And she's been one of the most invisible trainers of Metta Health, I would say. And a very visible one. I personally applaud Rashmi Arora because from where I knew her, and the kind of journey that she had to go through, the kind of new things or new languages that she had to learn. It wasn't just Hindi, English, but a new language every time she came back into a family. A new language to connect to her mom-in-law, a new language to connect to her husband, a new language to connect to her son, a new language to connect to her ailing father. And she did it all, guys. So, complete round of applause for her. Rashmi, if you can please do the last sharing right now. What kept you going?
Yes, that's my mother's love.
I didn't hear it, Rashmi.
My mother's love and my father's friendship.
Pura jahan pa liya inhone. My mother's love and my father's friendship. Pura jahan pa liya inhone aur phir bhi dhoond rahi hain ye ghar. Haan ji, continue.
My father's friendship is very different. I'm one of those three. I have two siblings and so they do not communicate to dad in a way I do. I can talk to him at length about anything. That's a pride.
Yes, and mom?
Mama's love is always there. She is a very, 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 very different lady. My mom is a very strong woman. Very, very strong. But she is the one. I remember one thing, you know what, Anu, I want to share. Way back in 2013, when I came for Rob's class for the first time to Bombay, I was very scared. Though I was a very outgoing person till 2001 or 2. But after that, I started becoming very submissive. So 2013, I had to come to Bombay all alone. And Anu said, you're going to stay in my house, don't worry. बट आई वुड से नो, मेरे को नहीं जाना है. इवन टिकट बुक हो गया, सब कुछ हो गया, नेक्स्ट डे ऑल्सो मुझे नहीं जाना, मुझसे नहीं जाया जाएगा, आई कांट गो. सो माय मदर स्टूड ओवर देयर एंड सेड, अब फैसला किया है ना तो जाना ही है, और जो फैसला किया है वो लेके आना ही है. एंड एवरी टाइम माय मॉम डज दैट, आई नो. इवन टुडे I called up Anu yesterday and said, Anu, there is something I'm not feeling good about. There is a problem in the family. I am not feeling so good. She said, karna hai. And before that, my mom had already said, Rashmi, you have to do it. You have already committed and you are going to do it. You're going to do the talk today. I was... It was 1987. I was selected Pan India out of 10 people who would visit the Doordarshan for a quiz program. And being selected out of 10 people in Pan India was a big thing for a child who did it on her own. Solving a quiz and being selected. That morning, unfortunately, we had a tragedy in the family and my Buaji passed away suddenly. That created a very, very mark in my perspective. And though, and every time, you know, one of my friends who is still here, Sarita, she must be here, she keeps on telling me, you keep on hiding from limelight. You take a back seat, always take a back seat. And I want you to do it because you are capable of doing it and you are worthy of doing it. So I would hide away from limelight from that day, probably going back. Today, when my mom said this, I knew I had. This is what it is. And obviously the love of my other sisters and whole family and their children and my children.
So Rashmi,
nothing. And one thing to mention also. There has been a lot of love and support, though in a very different way, from my husband. Thank you.
What's one message you will give to men of this country?
You know what? I would love to share something. Another friend is here, Archana Kumar. She's a lovely lady. I was sitting in a car, I think yesterday only, and she said something. I said, you know what? I have to learn from you. So to the men in the country, we women are as human as everybody. And it's not a fact that I'm a woman or I'm a man. I'm a human. And I also face the same issues with what other humans would do. But there are times where I am also like any other person, like, okay, I also need somebody to say, okay, main hu na, bas theek hai.
She wants Shah Rukh Khan, guys.
Shah Rukh Khan nahi chahiye.
Main hu na.
Shah Rukh Khan ka dialogue chahiye, magar Shah Rukh Khan nahi chahiye.
Got it. Very good. And what did you guys get from that? And just the last question, Rashmi, If there was a girl in your state, and we haven't spoken a lot, we've just covered the gap and gone ahead. Whenever you're ready next, we will talk about it, not just now. I promised you, so I didn't bring up anything. But, and I hate that word, but what can we use effectively?
You told me there's only one but in 2011. And still, I just remember now that, okay, there is one, but.
Absolutely.
The other one is just a preposition.
What will you tell another lady, another woman who went through or who is about to go through or is going through what you went through? We did not mention what she went through and are not going to. It's not required right now. But what will you say to the person?
I would not like anybody to go through what I have gone through. And anybody in my story or anybody else's in another story would not like that to happen. So it is, and we go through stories because it is our perspective to that story. So this story cannot, my story cannot be somebody else's story, but it could be a similar story. See, I told you the support from my family, and needless to mention my two brother-in-laws also. So keep going. That's it.
रुक जाना नहीं तू कहीं हार के. शाबाश, बाय बाय, सी यू.
थैंक यू.
इससे ज्यादा हम नहीं आपसे बुलवाएंगे, नहीं तो कहर हो जाएगा. प्लीज गाइस, कैन यू अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ एंड गिव अ राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज टू हर.
थैंक यू सो मच. सैल्यूट कहर होने वाला था, बच गए.
नहीं नहीं, ऐसा कुछ नहीं होगा, ऐसा कुछ नहीं होने वाला.
लव यू रश्मि मैम.
Okay.
Thank you. I love
Anybody
you.
Wants to share something, say something, or Rashmi, you want to share something, it's all good. If you want
Thanks, to share, Rashmi, to I share will. Your story, and very courageous and uplifting story, okay, for us, like, you know, for as a woman. So, awesome.
Thank you so much. I would like to cite a poem, which I do usually, and very favorite of mine. This was, woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep. This story, this poem has a Hindi version, which I really love, and that is, Gahan sagahan manmohak tarovar, mujhko aaj bulate hain. Kintu kiye jo vaade maine, yaad mujhe aa jaate hain. Abhi kahan aaram bandha hai. मूक निमंत्रण चलना है. अरे अभी तो मिलो मुझको चलना है. थैंक
यू. एंड विद दैट, भगवान ऐसे करे, काश ऐसा हो.
थैंक यू
कि आपको हर चीज जो आपको चाहिए वो हमेशा मिले.
एंड देयर इज, कैन आई शेयर वन थिंग मोर?
जरूर.
व्हिच चेंज्ड माय लाइफ. It is, I don't know whether I will be able to pronounce it in Urdu. That's what my father taught me. Tundiye mukhalif se na ghabra, ae aukab. Yeh to chalti hai tujhe uncha udane ke liye. This is, aukab is, I think, an eagle. Tundiye mukhalif is opposite winds. So it is, oh eagle, do not get threatened by the opposite winds. ये चलती हैं तुझे ऊंचा. दीज विंड्स मेक यू राइज हायर.
वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. यार आप इन सारे दोस्त इसके बेकार हो, अनम्यूट करके कुछ तो बोलो.
या बहुत है
एनी तमाशे.
हम तो रोज बात करते हैं.
चलो,
ये टोटली इनकनेक्ट.
ये 30 साल की फ्रेंडशिप है.
रोज
बात करते हैं और 30 साल हो गए. 1990 में हमारी फ्रेंडशिप हुई थी, मेरी और सोनिया की. सोनिया आप फोटो दिखा दे यार.
ये बहुत गंदी सुननी हुई.
कोई बात नहीं. सो 30 इयर्स एंड वी टॉक डेली. देयर इज अनदर वन, विभा, शी इज नॉट जॉइंड. तो हम लोग तीनों जने, मतलब हमारे पास फिर भी रोज बात करने के बाद भी कमी नहीं होती बात करने के लिए.
वही तो है, कमी कहाँ हुई प्यार की.
We are very proud of you, Rashmi.
Thank you, Sonia. I love
she
you.
Has been a pillar of strength to us. जब भी हमें कोई चाहिए ना, she has been there like a rock. मतलब खुद इतना सब सफर करके भी she is so strong, very stronger.
Very good.
Thank you, Rashmi.
दूसरे सारे दोस्त सो रहे हैं. अर्चना आप ही.
नाना कहाँ सो रहे हैं यार, गुलाबो.
आज मैं बोलने वाली, बोला था इसको मैंने, कहा तू ना मुझे गुलाबो बोलेगी. और हम रोज कभी साइकिल पे, कभी सड़क में. कल इसका पति बोलता है, तू मंदिर में मत्था टेके बिना आएगी नहीं ना.
वेरी गुड. सो
इट्स अ प्लेजर, इट्स एन एब्सोल्यूट प्लेजर.
माइन टू, लव यू.
एंड यू नो, फॉर पीपल हु डोंट नो, शी इज माय सीनियर फ्रॉम कॉलेज. And we just stay 50 meters apart. Hardcore competitors, dono tagde homeopathic and meta health practitioners. Khub sahi practice karte. Koi patient, aajkal online ka zamana na, I really want to share this with everyone. Patient phone karta hai, mereko. Ma'am, aapke charges kya hai? Bata dete hai. मैम ये प्रॉब्लम है, बता दिया, कहानी खत्म. मैम अपॉइंटमेंट, आ जाओ, कहानी खत्म. फिर वो पेशेंट रश्मि को फोन करता है, मैम आपके चार्जेस क्या है, क्योंकि हम 50 मीटर दूर रहते हैं दोनों का क्लिनिक. एंड मैम आपके चार्जेस क्या, एंड बिफोर द पेशेंट कॉल्स हर आई टेल हर ओए ये फोन आने वाला है,
या मैं उसे कॉल कर देती
हूं, या ये मुझे फोन करके बताती हूं ओए फोन आने वाला है.
और वो पेशेंट आएगा
ना, इससे वो पेशेंट ना इसके पास आता है ना मेरे पास आता है, क्योंकि उसको पता ही है दोनों का सब कुछ बराबर है.
Got it.
Oh God.
एक बन के रहना.
Blessing. 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 Absolute blessing.
It's a blessing to be a friend with her. आपको we did not meet for so many years. पहले हम कॉलेज के बाद कुछ समय गायब हो गए. दोनों मिले, so we were both expecting in 2000 and we met at Pizza Hut and we said, कहाँ रहते हो? पता चला वो हम तो पड़ोस में रहते हैं. उसके बाद बहुत सारी चीजें हुई, कभी मूविंग आउट ऑफ द कंट्री, मूविंग इन द कंट्री एंड ऑल, एंड देन वी लॉस्ट सम ट्रैक. एंड वन फाइन डे आई वेंट टू अ कॉन्फ्रेंस वेयर वन ऑफ माय वेरी ब्यूटीफुल फ्रेंड कविता, शी कॉल्ड मी, शी सेड कम बैक टू द होम्योपैथिक वर्ल्ड नाउ, लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस विद माइंड लाइक माइंड पीपल विद फॉर यू. सो देयर आई वेंट देयर, आई स्टूड एट द गेट एंड अर्चना कुमार स्टैंडिंग देयर, शी सेड ओए तू कवे तू कहां से. And I must mention something about her. Sorry, taking a lot of time. This girl was a very chilly person. So, अभी क्या हुआ कि मेटा हेल्थ तो आता था, तो मैंने इसकी थेरेपीज ली. And उससे पहले ना हम लोग गए जयपुर, all friends, four friends, we went to Jaipur and we stayed in a hotel. And मैं बहुत extremely hot person हूँ, मुझे AC on चाहिए full blast. इसको इसने क्या किया, इस मैंने कहा मैं तो नहीं सो सकती. एंड सोनिया एंड विभा एंड बदी एडजेसेंट रूम, हम दोनों एक्सट्रीम्स एक साथ. कहती है रुक, इसने चढ़ाई टोपी, एक स्वेटर, दो स्वेटर, एक पता नहीं इनर, और नीचे भी दो तीन इनर चढ़ा के कहती है, रजाई लेके कहती है, ठीक है चला ले जो चलाना है. She's so adjusted. तो उसके बाद इसकी मैंने थेरेपी ली, उसको वो चिलीनेस थी वो खत्म हो गई, फॉर सम रीजन थेरेपी ली थी. तो ये कहती है, एक दिन इसका हस्बैंड बोलता है, ओए यार तेरा तो थर्मोस्टेट खराब हो गया, तू तो फुल ब्लास्ट एसी चला रही है.
चलो यहां से आपको ये समझ
के बोलना है. मैम आई आल्सो वांट टू से समथिंग अबाउट रश्मि. जिस जयपुर ट्रिप की मैम बात कर रही है ना, आई वाज देयर विद अर्चना मैम एंड रश्मि मैम. एंड मैंने जैसे पहले भी बोला है कि मैं ना पहले गूंगी होती थी, नहीं बोलती थी, ठीक है. मैं रश्मि मैम एक साइड में बैठी थी, एक साइड में अर्चना मैम बैठी थी, और मैं बीच में गूंगे बन के बैठी थी. जयपुर दिल्ली से इट्स ऑलमोस्ट 4 to 5 hours जर्नी, जाते टाइम की जर्नी, आते टाइम की जर्नी, मुंह पे टेप. कुछ नहीं बोला मैंने, कुछ नहीं बोला. दोनों ने डिसाइड करा इसको तो बुलवा के छोड़ेंगे. आते टाइम मैंने एक दो कुछ शब्द बोल दिए, एंड फ्रॉम देयर मतलब मेरी मैम के साथ जर्नी स्टार्ट हुई. एंड now we are really good and very close friends. हम लोग रात को डेढ़ डेढ़ दो दो बजे तक बात करते रहते हैं. घर वाले सोचते हैं पता नहीं क्या कर रहे हैं, दोनों girlfriend boyfriend बन चुके हैं. And I'm really happy that I met Rashmi ma'am and she is real gem. And I love you.
Love you too.
और I'm really happy कि आज आपने उनको limelight में डाल दिया. मैं उनके पीछे पड़ी हुई इतने दिन से कि ये कर लो, आपको करनी पड़ेगी.
अभी भी पूरी कहानी नहीं सुनाई है हमने, मुझसे वापस आएंगे.
I know.
थोड़ा सा उनको आज confidence दिया है. So this is where I want you guys to understand.
May I?
When you start your journey of transformation, who is this? May I? Please talk.
Amita.
Please talk, Amita.
Hello, Rashmi ma'am.
Hi, Amita. How are you?
I am good, ma'am, and I am so happy to see you. And as you said, na ki koi bolne wala chahiye, main hoon na. Whenever I feel low, I seriously see you standing at back of me.
Love you.
Thank you so much.
Love you.
Love you too, ma'am.
बच्चे छोटे बच्चों ने इनको कवर किया था, तो सारी जिंदगी ये लोगों को कवर करती है. You know, सम लम्हे हमारी जिंदगी के बहुत बड़ी कहानी छोड़ जाते हैं. कुछ लोग हमारी जिंदगी में हमें अधूरा छोड़ जाते हैं, कुछ लोग हमारी जिंदगी में हमें पूरा कर जाते हैं. पर असली इंसान वो है जो खुद को पूरा करने के लिए हर वो काम करता है और अपने आप को समझने के लिए, अपने आप को मुकम्मल बनाने के लिए कुछ भी करता है. एंड रश्मि इज डेफिनेटली द वुमन ऑफ सब्सटेंस एंड शी डिड एवरीथिंग दैट शी कुड सो फार टू ट्रांसफॉर्म हरसेल्फ. सो कुडोज टू हर. एंड वी गो टू द नेक्स्ट स्पीकर ऑफ द डे, करुणा. Karuna is going to be